When a nuclear bomb or missile explodes near the ground, great quantities of earth and debris are sucked up into the fireball and carried by the prevailing winds before falling back to earth. This material is radioactive fallout. The particles look like grains of salt or sand.
What's going on, guys? It's Greg here, aka NYPrepper. It is Thursday, November 2nd, 2023, and I have an emergency alert to share with you guys. So last night, the U.S. House of Representatives passed a resolution declaring that a nuclear-armed Iran cannot be permitted under any circumstances, and that the U.S. will use all means necessary to prevent that outcome. So this is huge news, guys. This is basically a declaration of war against Iran by the U.S. House of Representatives. So the resolution on Iran's nuclear program passed by 354 to 53 votes, only 50 Democrats, largely progressives, and three Republicans opposed this resolution. The legislation declares that it is U.S. policy that a nuclear-armed Iran cannot be permitted under any circumstances, and that the U.S. will use all means necessary to prevent that outcome. It also expresses American support for the freedom of action of partners and allies, including Israel, to prevent Iran from obtaining a nuclear weapon. So this is huge news, guys. Not only does this resolution say that the U.S. can use all means necessary to prevent Iran from getting nuclear weapons, but that it will also allow Israel and other allies to take action against Iran to prevent them from getting a nuclear weapon. So this is huge, guys. Absolutely huge. It looks like the U.S. is setting up for a massive strike on Iran, and Putin signed a law revoking the ratification of the nuclear test ban treaty by Russia. So this would allow Russia to test nuclear weapons underwater and in the atmosphere. Okay, so that is absolutely huge. And last night, we had a presidential doomsday plane that turned its transponder off over northwestern Missouri. So what you're looking at here is a presidential doomsday plane and two aerial refueler planes. And they were all flying together just north of Kansas City. And then the presidential doomsday plane turned its transponder off. As you can see here, we only see two planes here and then three planes here. Okay, so it turned its transponder off as soon as it got into northwestern Missouri. And it never turned its transponder back on. And that's very concerning, especially with the two aerial refuelers flying with it. That is very, very concerning. I don't know if that's an exercise. I don't know if this was a real deal situation and they deployed the doomsday plane in the air just in case with the aerial refuelers. There might have been some kind of intelligence that spooked them. So for good measure, they deployed it. But the presidential doomsday plane is used by the U.S. president in the event of a nuclear war. He would go on that plane and command the entire U.S. nuclear arsenal from the air. So this is very, very concerning. And also last night we had several U.S. aerial refuelers fly over Saudi Arabia in a single file. And then they went into the Mediterranean. And some people believe this was preparation for a strike on Yemen, possibly. So I want to just continue with some breaking news that happened overnight. So the general of the Ukrainian army, Valery Zaluzhny, said that the war with Russia has reached an impasse, and to break it, a major technological breakthrough would be needed, and that is not likely. Iran's president said the U.S. is the main cause of Israeli crimes in Gaza. U.S. President Joe Biden and Chinese leader Xi Jinping will meet in San Francisco in November, And we have a Hamas official, Ghazi Hamad, telling a Lebanese news outlet LBCI this week that Israel as a country has no place to exist and we must remove that country. And he said, we will repeat the October 7 attacks time and time again until Israel is annihilated. That's what one of the senior Hamas officials said. And the Israeli Defense Forces spokesman said that the Israeli army is continuing its offensive in the Gaza City area and is expanding its fighting, destroying Hamas defense lines in the northern Gaza Strip. And it appears that the Eisenhower carrier strike group has slowed down. And it makes me wonder if the Eisenhower carrier strike group is going to actually stay in the Eastern Mediterranean rather than going to the Arabian Sea and the Persian Gulf, which was stated by the Defense Department here in the U.S. that they were going to move this thing just south of Iran. But it appears to have slowed down dramatically in the last 2 to 3 days. It's been hanging out just southwest of Crete, so not too far away from the other carrier strike group. And my guess is that they don't want to go through the Red Sea with the carrier strike group because of the Yemen rebels, the Houthi rebels that have all the missiles. And also there's Iranian missile ships in the Red Sea. So we'll have to wait and see where this second aircraft carrier ends up staying. And Jordan informed Yemen that it will not allow its airspace to be used against Israel. Saudi Arabia also opposed Yemen's request to use its airspace against Israel. And the Yale Daily News, the independent student newspaper and oldest college daily in the country, retracted an editor's notes that targeted a pair of recent pro-Israel columns after huge backlash. The editor's notes took issue with statements that Hamas raped women and called them unsubstantiated claims. Okay, so an Ivy League school, Yale University, their newspaper, was posting stuff that Hamas raping women in Israel was unsubstantiated claims. So that's pretty much it for this one, guys. Just wanted to give you this quick update. So the U.S. House of Representatives passing a resolution declaring that a nuclear-armed Iran cannot be permitted under any circumstances, and the U.S. will use all means necessary to prevent that. And it will also support the freedom of action of partners and allies, including Israel, to prevent Iran from obtaining a nuclear weapon, and Putin signing a law revoking the ratification of the nuclear test ban treaty. So I'll be back later this afternoon or this evening with another update. So until then, take care, God bless, and don't forget the three P's: prepare, practice, and persevere.